How does a bastard, orphan, son of a whore and a Scotsman, dropped in the middle of a forgotten spot in the Caribbean by Providence, impoverished and squalor, grow up to be a hero and a scholar?
The $10 founding father without a father got a lot farther by working a lot harder, by being a lot smarter, by being a self-starter. By 14, they placed him in charge of a trading charter.
And every day while slaves were being slaughtered and carted away across the waves, he struggled and kept his guard up. Inside, he was longing for something to be a part of. The brother was ready to beg, steal, borrow, or barter.
Then a hurricane came and devastation reigned. Our man saw his future drip, dripping down the drain. Put a pencil to his temple, connected it to his brain, and he wrote his first refrain, a testament to his pain.
Well, the word got around, they said this kid is insane, man. Took up a collection just to send him to the mainland. Get your education, don't forget from whence you came, and the world's gonna know your name. What's your name, man?
Alexander Hamilton. My name is Alexander Hamilton, and there's a million things I haven't done. But just you wait, just you wait.
When he was 10, his father split, full of it, debt-ridden. 2 years later, see Alex and his mother bedridden, half dead, sitting in their own sick, the scent thick.
And Alex got better, but his mother went quick.
Moved in with a cousin, the cousin committed suicide. Left him with nothing but ruined pride. Something new inside a voice saying,
Alex, you gotta fend for yourself.
He started retreating and reading every treatise on the shelf.
There would have been nothing left to do for someone less astute. He would have been dead or destitute without a cent or restitution. Started working, clerking for his late mother's landlord, trading sugar cane and rum and all the things he can't afford. Scamming for every book he can get his hands on, planning for the future.